to the horse races. All I had is Smackdown. I hope my audio mix is good. So, what are you guys doing?
We're just being jackasses and referencing Splatterhouse and Stream Chat.
I can't see it!
Well, just know that you smell of rot of the grave.
That's not true. I shower every day.
Oh my god, this thing's just... the page just crashed.
Oh, jeez.
Oops.
Who's Buck?
Okay, so I'm gonna show you the move It Bites a Forehead, because my character has it. Also, the female bodies in this game, for some reason, they don't seem to have any neck. So my character just has, like, this fucking beef-ass neck going on. Alright, so let's... Here we go. It bites the forehead.
I'm waiting for with anticipation. There we go.
Oh my goodness.
Pretty good move. Also,
maybe it's a reference to Stephen King.
Oh, what the hell was that?
It bites the forehead, man.
Classic wrestling moves.
Okay, so... You suggested that we make a wrestler on stream.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
I did that.
Yeah. So do you have any idea of who we can make?
The Rock. You know, the wrestler? That'd be crazy.
That would be wild.
Just turn him into the, Rock... just turn him into the guy from Part 4 who turned into a rock.
But at the minute, all I can think about is Vic Taylor and Splatterhouse, because I was just streaming that.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see if we can do that, actually. Although I don't know anything about Splatterhouse, aside from the fact that, he's a big, beefy man with a, hockey mask. And,
so you know everything about Vic Taylor, then.
Yeah. Alright, so we got our, very worried-looking default man here.
Don't make me look stupid.
Now, if you have a kabuki mask, that'll work too, apparently.
Yeah, there's like a bunch of variants. Hockey mask, skull mask, kabuki mask.
A lot of masks that aren't gonna fulfill our purpose here.
Honestly, just get a white mask. That's all you really need.
Wait, yeah, true.
What was that? Oh, I thought that was a question mark.
I forgot how much choice this PS1 game had.
This lion mask.
Make it blank and, just make him the question.
Oh. That lion mask is amazing.
Oh my god.
That's not even a mask, it's just his face.
That's brilliant.
Alright, so I think this is the closest we're gonna get to it. I think if we give him, like, something underneath to make, like, the eyes black, I think it should work.
Mm.
Yeah, that'll be good.
Alright, so... And yeah, I really don't miss the, this way to color items in games anymore, let me tell you.
Variation?
Yeah, I don't know either.
Is that the hue, or...?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now that...
I think I've heard that term before, but that's still weird.
Yeah, I mean, now that Bob has pointed out that this actually is a Japanese game, I'm starting to see evidence of it all over the place. Does glasses work under the mask? It works over the mask! So,
well...
Now he looks like the Invisible Man. Hold on, do we have, like, makeup or anything?
Just wearing shades. Vic Taylor crossed over to Gemini.
Oh my god.
Big Rick.
Oh wait, we got paint. Oh no. Should work good enough. The eyes will still be visible, but.
Well, I mean, technically, that's not inaccurate.
Yeah. Now we just. Oh.
That looks pretty. Actually, yeah, I'm happy with that.
All right. So he just has like a ripped V-neck, I think.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll do research for you.
Okay.
That's Splatterhouse 2, the skull face.
You just look like a janitor, really. I don't
pretty
really
much.
Know what's going.
There's the skull face, and then there's like the other skull face. Also, I didn't realize at the time, but I did Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection, and then I streamed Splatterhouse 3. I just realized that fucking Terror Mask is in both games.
Yeah, it's pretty something. So, I'm just gonna make a really small V-neck. If he has one.
It mostly just looks like a t-shirt with the sleeves ripped off, I think.
Yeah, well.
Maybe they're using three.
There's different variations, really.
I'm also familiar with the green outfit.
I'll get a picture of that as well.
Oh no, what is this?
What?
Yeah, this is exactly what Rick Taylor looks like.
Oh dear.
That's like the Batman and Robin version of Rick.
I might as well get the last one of him, like Splatterhouse 1.
Yeah, like I'm getting a whole bunch of different results, and I don't know which of these are actually official art or which of these is like fan art.
that Bane-looking one, that is totally official.
Oh yeah, absolutely. He absolutely was a sprite edit of Zangief on the Sega Genesis.
I love how whenever anybody sprite edits, people are like, okay, what do we have to work with? Well, we have Street Fighter Alpha and nothing else.
Well, no, they edited Super Scroll out of Sabretooth from X-Men vs. Street Fighter for no reason.
Marvel vs. Capcom. There we go.
It really is like a Capcom game. There you go.
Yeah.
God, this color selection's so weird.
Yeah. The other game I had used to do it like this, too.
I guess a variation just means hue, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
So we're pretty much done here.
But it makes, like, such an easy character design.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His moves would just be punching a lot.
What about, a spin kick?
Oh, Christ. Yeah, that has to be the finisher.
You know, there actually are plenty of spin kicks in this game, so...
Perfect.
So what should he say for yes?
Oh god. Well, you should go oh, hang on, let me find it. Give me a second.
Triple exclamation point.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give him the Val Venus entrance. signs, whatever.
I like how the long play Jennifer dies. Like, gets the fucking bad ending.
And the no will just be question marks.
Shit, I wanna find this clip.
Sorry,
Professor Zio says, what?
hang on, just a second. I found it.
No.
This should be him, saying no.
Not too far from what I put in, so I can go back and change it. So he'll be great in hardcore matches because all the weapons and stuff.
God, why in the new game did he just have like this Bane-like body with this tiny ass head?
No idea. He will be.
That's a timestamp for what I want his finisher to look like.
We can make him be called the Dark Knight.
Where are they? Where's my friend?
Where's Jennifer? Tell me!
And he is on... he is on bad terms with Grandmaster Sexay. There we go. let's just make him, like, just general powerful stats.
I mean, he can throw, but generally just punches people.
Yeah,
he punches, throws, and occasionally does a spin kick.
Hardcore and attack. This is the character we're gonna be playing as, by the way, even though I'm, like... I myself is in the roster, but that's even funnier. Just to see if I can feud with myself. So now we move on to the moves, which I'm not going to be spending too much time with. Since
God, they really upskilled this, didn't they?
Hmm.
Like, I mean, like, the fonts are really clean for a PS1 game.
Yeah. With this and Kensei, I'm seeing some things that not a lot of people did on this platform. Because Kensei was, like, oddly really high res for a PS1 game.
Yeah.
Alright, so. Now we edit the moves.
No wonder I enjoy this game so much. Just the amount of stuff you can edit.
Yeah, you can. I mean, you can edit this much, but the main draw is that this one's actually fun to play.
He kind of just has his hands by his sides.
Yeah, nothing too special.
Let's give him Steve Blackburn. There we go.
He's gotta have his hands by his side.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can give him an Eddie stance.
Yeah. You can basically just make Eddie, because they pretty much have all his moves in this game.
Yay!
I don't think I've ever seen Rick Taylor pose in any of these games.
Yeah, we're just gonna have to improvise here. D'Lo Brown.
You're dealing with a real D'Lo.
Ho-train?
And he just punches you and your head explodes.
Ho-train is pretty good.
It should be like just sort of the Ho-train.
We're gonna have to go with Ho-train for the first one.
I don't think Jennifer would like that.
what other suggestions do you have?
Well, like just showing off his muscles, I guess. Like, I'm a mutant freak that's been possessed.
Oh, I forgot I actually made a bunch. Hold on,
See those.
This is my first one.
If you want something fitting, then pretty much just pointing and being like, I'm gonna fucking kill you.
This is just the guy from... This is just Jedi Ryan from Dragon Master. This is my... Wait, no. That's my other one. This is basically just me getting used to it. Then I just have the standard Mortal Kombat 1 ninja pose for a ninja killer. And yeah, that's what I made. So,
this is amazing, wow.
Yeah, do they even still have these in the new games? Like, I think they took
They've got shitloads of... No, seriously, they've got thousands of just every single year they add more, and they've been doing this for like, what, like 17 years now?
It's just that the paces of the games got muddier and muddier.
Yeah, this is like simulation style now, which isn't fun.
Yeah, I don't know why people love that shit. It's so boring.
It's not fun to play, no. The problem with making characters in that is that they're so detailed that you don't really have it. Like, making Rick in that would be... If you put in enough time, you can make him look exactly right.
Yeah.
Which is actually a detriment, because it takes way too long to edit every little texture.
Yeah. So, with his moves, I'm just gonna give him, like, the slide kick.
Yeah.
And then give him, customize his auto combo, and, give him a kick finisher?
Definitely needs, like, a... Yeah!
Then you mentioned the
Roundhouse getting this one more thing as well. I don't think Kelexo's seen this, but he does have a kind of a pile driver.
Oh, I've seen that.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that'll work out fine then.
I don't know if a wrestling game would have a pile driver, though. That's just weird.
Well, it's right here.
What?
Okay, so we got that covered. Special
actually, I think it's more of a choke. Oh shit, he needs a choke lift as well. I'm sorry, I'm very pedantic.
That's fine, I'll remember.
Because he has this and a headbutt and okay, I'll try and slow it down. Just headbutt and a choke, and then I'll be happy. I promise.
Oh wait, we can just give him this choke finisher.
THQ slam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna give him, like, a general just boxing auto combo here.
It's like a jab, a body punch, and then an uppercut, if that's any help.
Okay, hold on. Jab.
What?
Okay, hello. Jab. Hi, we're streaming, get in.
We're making Rick Taylor in a wrestling game.
Yeah.
Which stream am I going to?
Melvana.
Oh, you got it.
What else did you say, Ed?
So he does a jab, a body punch, and then ends it with an uppercut.
Okay, that's easy enough.
I want to know how big this man is. What do you mean, Chow Melvana and Chance? Doesn't it fucking help me?
This is Melvana.
There we go.
Giving this really over the top uppercut. There we go. Alright. We are set. Now we're gonna go into season mode. Which I noticed now that I just filled in the unused list, they just keep putting my wrestlers in the hardcore section. I'm not really sure why that is, but they seem to be showing up more, so there's that. Alright, now that we got all that sorted out, let's bust some heads, or get our heads busted, which usually seems to be the case here.
Let us bust a move.
Oh no.
New game. First year, yes.
I don't know what this guy looks like, so I'm ready.
Yeah, you came in at just as we got done making him. Alright,
King Rogers.
Yeah, he's in here, and I'm very happy with how he came out, so. Alright, let's see if our guy's gotten any of the matches. If not, I can just skip them. That's Taisaki, it's Manny, and... Okay, so, we got one match where we're in there.
Kurt
Angle. Versus Bradshaw.
Okay, we're just gonna skip the... Oh, we already got a cutscene. Let's see.
I'm just gonna refresh.
Yeah. It's Kane! Kane is here! And that's all you need to know.
Hello, Kane.
I mean, I thought, like...
Goodbye, Kane!
I thought promos were bad these days, but apparently yeah. Even worse back then.
And Andrew WK won the match.
So where is the Colonel?
He's probably in Fire Pro or something at this point.
Oh god, Pat Patterson! I forgot he's a character in this.
Isn't he like a Hulk Hogan replacement in like two of these games?
Oh Jesus, that's weird. Yeah.
Albert!
Yeah, Albert beat a retired man.
Alright, let's see what this cutscene is. Steve Austin just bitches into a mic and then
Well, I am here. Who is my opponent?
And Lauren's...
And that's the bottom line.
And Lauren's blood is very confused.
Jeez, it didn't look like him. Except I don't remember Lawrence. Lawrence called like just saying 9.99 over and over.
Okay, so we got our match here.
I had a dinner date and I had to cancel it for this match.
All right, so we're just fighting this guy.
Oh, fucking JBL! Beat the hell out of him. He sucks.
JBL.
That's what he goes by nowadays. He's a commentator and he's terrible. He just keeps going, I see what you mean, my girl!
Alright, well,
I'll
try beating the shit out of him for you then.
I forget
he's also like, he was like a massive asshole as well.
Oh, jeez.
He's apparently a massive appa.
Alright, well, here's our entry.
What did you choose? I didn't even see you choose it.
Malvinus.
Holy!
Mindless party going on, and Rick Taylor's invited.
That was a little more techno-y than the one I used to see as a kid.
Why is he in a rave? He's like the last person to go to a rave or strip club.
There are demons in the rave. He's gotta go get it.
I heard Jennifer is here.
Alright, so we got our match and... we're getting Paul Drive here. Not Paul Drive.
Jennifer smells a rot of ecstasy.
I was gonna say, but the APA had this t-shirt they had for sale. It was the unintentional most gay shirt ever, because it said APA always pounding ass.
No.
Like, no sense of irony to that.
Make him CPR real quick. Alright, he's alive.
Rick's gonna go jogging.
Basically, how I play any of these games is I run away, and then I run back.
So you're a cowardly heel.
Yeah, pretty much. we got the camera angles going.
Bradshaw is the evil one.
Apparently not entirely untrue. God, his auto combo is so laggy now.
Lift him up like a fucking pizza, shit.
Special delivery, Bradshaw pie.
There's a lot special about this, but I don't think a pie is one of them.
I'm just picturing me just jumping on a monster and just punching it.
Oh, damn. Oh, damn!
I love how that's in, like, almost every wrestling game. What the f- Oh god, it's Farouk!
Farouk is here! And he has challenged you. Watch your ass.
I don't know who the fuck that guy is. Who is he?
I actually know who he is, sort of, in that I've seen him, but I don't really know who he is.
He's
gonna watch him beat the shit out of his friend?
Yeah, he didn't really do anything, did he?
How is that not a DQ?
Yeah, really.
I love how he's the info guy's at the ring in this game.
Goodbye.
Come on, turn around so we can do our finisher.
Oh my god, I love the air throw.
Yeah.
Just like the original Tekken's.
Yeah. I was thinking that too. Come on. Oh, we just had our finisher and then he flew out of the ring.
He had to go.
Rick, what are you doing?
I'm waiting for the ten count. What the fuck?
He's like Splatterhouse 3, that kick is very powerful.
You're waiting for a guy with knives run in and say, "Whoa!"
I just gotta get him stunned and then do the finisher and I'll probably knock him out right then. Oh no! I just got right back up from that. That was
Jesus, clothesline from hell.
Yeah. And he was just like, nah, I'm good. Because I know everybody just has a ways of pin, and I forget the commandos for it all the time. Come on. Oh, Jesus.
You can just hurt him a lot, that works too.
Yeah. Oh, jeez.
Just try and wait for him and then just counter.
Yeah. Oh, I'm stunned now. Okay. Damn it. Oh, I did a switch on him. And I picked him off like a pizza again and then.
I think you've.
Yeah, turn around, you idiot. What are you doing?
Donk it.
Yeah, you kind of looking at Farouk.
Yeah, the focusing in this game is kind of weird.
You should turn on those indicators. They help a lot.
Ah, fair enough.
About to do another fucking big finisher.
Ah, gee. No. Rope break. Yeah, rope break, you asshole. What are you doing? We got our finisher.
I guess the Acolytes would be in service of the evil one.
Ah, we got him. That just knocked him the fuck out.
Shit.
I didn't even edit our win post, so I don't even know what it is.
Lambzos?
don't ass whip him. It's a good message. That's his win pose.
Don't ass whip him.
He just kind of stares at everyone.
Well, you know, he does a lot of that, I think.
Takes a turnbuckle to the leg, just lets it clip through.
He's gonna freeze again after his victory.
So, since three custom characters are in this one, I think we're gonna have to watch this one.
We do, yeah. And Crash.
I've seen him pop up a lot so far. Which is annoying me because I don't know who he is.
He's just not much.
You know what? I didn't know who Manny was. I thought Crash was the custom character, and I thought it was literally Crash Bandicoot.
Why this entrance? This doesn't fit Manny at all. That entrance.
This woman, and he's really confused. Oh no! Get me away from these women! No!
Wow.
Women here!
There's demons.
Always pounding ass.
Apple.
Oh wow, that looks too good.
Thanks.
It says Apple protection. I just imagine it's just really fucking good condoms.
Why is he holding a fake rocket?
That's a condom.
Oh, okay.
It's just a big tube full of them, dude.
And here's Ninja Killer.
I think I'm more so asking, why is it in this game?
Because.
I can't even answer that.
Apple protection, dude.
Here's this asshole. He's carrying
a
thing with
dice. And...
Crash.
I don't know why he's carrying a scale with him.
Because I can only just remember. I think there's something about him being a light heavyweight or something, and he just wanted to prove it.
He's weighing every single game of the Crash Bandicoot series. He just wants to know how much they weigh stacked together.
That'd probably be a better gimmick than what he had.
By disc, by the way. Like, the box. You don't need the boxes. It's by disc.
He had a feud with someone because they were including the box, and he got really angry.
Yeah, it was a mess.
Okay, so now we gotta see how this goes. I think we need to turn the player indicator off since we're not playing this.
I don't know, I wanna know when someone's gonna crank out a fucking sick finisher.
Hopefully one of my custom characters. That's all I'm hoping for.
I'll be really upset if Crash wins.
I want Manny to win because I don't know who the fuck this guy is. He just looks like a goober.
He's a character from a funny show. Sorry,
who runs from women? That's pretty funny.
Vernon, no! It's women!
I hope his win pose is like playing the piano or something.
Gets really tired because this is supposed to be going after like that pot of espresso.
You do like an alternate version of Manny at 88 degrees.
Come to Fire Pro incarnation, yeah. Even so far isn't really fighting, he's just kind of darting around the ring.
I forgot how goddamn fast this game is.
What the? Did Crash really just win?
Spoilers?
Yeah, he won.
Jesus Christ, man, he's a wimp! It's like giving him like a Chinese burn. He goes, I just can't give up.
Oh man, men are rough. I don't know if I can handle this. I think I'll go back to the women.
Why does Beavis have a Muay Thai stance?
Because he just reminds me a lot of Hwan Jai.
Alright.
Okay, so I think. I actually, because that one episode where he's like, my knee gets really cramped when I'm stressed, I think I actually gave him an injured knee stat because of that.
Wow.
And also now that guy we just saw pop up versus that guy from that Samurai Showdown Amiga game. Because I just had to make him. Seeing APA a lot.
Yeah. Appa is everywhere.
Mostly because they just have the best theme, I guess.
It's pretty good.
And then,
I think they just really want to sell those condoms, man.
Ben always dies. Pounding us.
gotta stay protected.
Who's acting pretty martial law right now.
You know, Funaki from Kai and Tai is now the Japanese commentator for them.
Oddly prophetic, I suppose.
Every time I see martial arts in wrestling, I just wonder, why the fuck are you here? Don't you have, like, something, like, way above your league you should be doing? Like, yes. Actual fighting?
Yeah, Tai Saki.
That's why they're in wrestling.
Tai Saki's just gonna hit somebody in the head with a head. That's a sticker in the elbow. Then he just gets... Come on, dude, he had such a strong start, now you're like...
He's gotta get hit by the fucking baguette real quick.
Like a million times, Jesus.
Really likes that bread, man.
He hasn't watched his ass, sir.
Caution!
Oh,
thanks for grabbing the air there.
Thanks, Tope, more crazy.
What the hell was that?
Sure.
That was like a Jun counter.
Yeah.
I'm going to post this message to you in Discord since it seems as though someone wants you to see it.
Yeah, someone named Tope more crazy.
Oh, wait, that guy popped up? Huh.
They are still talking.
Well, tell
Whoa, that was weird.
Tell him I can't actually see the chat.
Just did?
Yeah, way to go.
Good job, you did it! Like, I bet you like bread, you son of a bitch. Oh, I guess not. Everyone's a critic.
So, he's getting his ass kicked a lot, and then he just does that counter. And then he resumes getting hit in the face with a wooden stick over and over.
I like this game, but this does not even vaguely resemble an actual wrestling match. There's no psychology, there's no pacing, it's just
That's why I prefer it.
True. I don't blame you, it's cool, but...
Every time he tries to do something, he just gets hit in the face.
I was gonna say rope break, but this is a hardcore match.
Oh yeah.
We don't need no bitch ass rules like rope break.
I never understood rope break in a game. I mean, like in real life, I kind of understand, but here it's just like.
No, what happens is you're a bitch.
At least you can turn them off.
Yeah. As he.
Like, if you didn't include it, if you didn't include it, it would just seem like you screwed up.
Finisher, huh?
I can't even remember it.
Wow,
he didn't even get a one after his finisher. He's not selling.
Yeah.
It's like really difficult to work with.
And Tai Saki is actually starting to do things.
Oh shit.
And then he got kicked in the. Alright.
So, like, in actual wrestling, a belly-to-belly suplex out of the ring would be, like, a really big deal. In this game, they just happen all the time.
Raw is more, man. Just gonna pick up my stick and wait for you here.
I'm gonna donkey kick.
Damn!
Why did you just stand there? Dude! I want to see where this goes.
He just was like, you're tired? Maybe I should let you have a good rest. I'm sorry, buddy.
What's his finisher?
I think it's the Stone Cold Stunner.
Okay.
Oh, beautiful. The Stunner is the best finisher in gaming history.
Basically, the way I pick finishers in this game, and also Fire Pro, is just whatever stats that they happen to have, whichever one just kind of has the most ends up being their finisher. Jeez, he's not staying down.
He is burying Farouk with his not selling his finisher.
Yeah, really?
Ty's just like, it's a pain in the ass to work with and everyone hates him.
He got hit! That's the third time and he still hasn't gone down. He's like the Rocky with it. Whoa!
Ow, my back.
Oh my god.
Stunner.
Oh my god.
Fucking burying Farouk.
He did three finishes on him and didn't do shit. He did one and then he won.
See, it was the fucking stunner, so...
Yeah. He's politicking behind the scenes, I'm sorry.
Unarguably the best finisher in wrestling history, the stunner. Next to Sweet Chin Music.
Yeah.
Wow, Farouk. He just fucking punched the cameraman, that's...
I'd be mad, too.
You just got lucky when you kicked out of my finisher three times.
Yeah, really. Skipping this.
Man, just got luck.
I like how they have life bars here. Just to say that's not totally random, I guess.
You gotta fucking Stone Cold Bear not lose this bitch.
Back in the day when Kane was actually like, could be in a put in a match with those two.
Oh, well, he didn't lose. He didn't lose all of his life bars.
Mr. Ass was a special event for that for some reason.
Who's booking this? This is terrible.
Hi, my name is Billy Gunn, and this is...
I'm an ass man.
Billy... Billy Gunn won?
I think he was just a ref.
Yeah, it's...
No, the winner thing was right next to his name, so he won.
Raw is all.
Raw is all?
Okay, I prefer to be that as boys. Aww.
So, now we got the guy from Dragon Master and Ninja Killer versus basically two porno actors.
I was into porno once.
Billy Gunn, who has like seven times over the limit for steroids.
It's all that ass, man.
So Jedi Ryan was in that fucking Star Wars parody, right?
Dragon Master was a Star Wars parody. Yes. Also, Triple H is here, just so you know.
Triple H is here.
Yeah.
Hello. Wait a second, didn't fucking Kane lose? Like, didn't he get knocked out and everything?
I don't know, because he was only in one match.
Yeah, I think he actually got knocked out. Like, not only did he lose, he got knocked out of that triple threat match. He was the reason someone else won. Good job.
Well, he's here. I mean, they didn't say he'd be any good.
You're not lying.
Also, yeah, there's Jedi Ron. Not much else you can really say about him.
Yeah, that's the studio. The studio's a thing in Raw. Light the camera action, right, guys?
Ninja Killer again. Who I actually based this moveset off of that one dude in Kensei.
Melv, did I tell you about... You know that guy I was really excited about seeing, Finn Balor?
Right.
He won the first ever Universal Championship, his first ever pay-per-view, and he won. During the match, he suffered an injury, and he now has to be out for 6 months, and he had to relinquish the title. That's like,
bullshit!
That's really like the one thing I wanted to get back into wrestling to see, and he just fucking injures himself and he's out for 6 months. And, god damn it.
And here's possibly one of the worst characters in this entire.
Oh man!
Yeah.
Oh god, that face chased you as well.
Yeah, that was the thing that happened. I want everybody to remember that. That was the thing.
I think they put all the polygons in his ass.
Yeah, that was a thing that happened in real life, and people were like, yep, that's good.
I like how he has, like, a pair of lips right on his dick, because it's the closest thing to a blowjob you'll ever get.
Holy shit.
Have you heard his summary of the Attitude Era?
No.
I'm gonna find it. It's only 5 seconds long.
I can't really listen to it, so...
I know you can't, everyone else can.
Thanks, Ninja Killer.
Well, I guess they're all naked.
I'll get naked, you'll get naked. The crazier the better.
Wow, wow. As a avid shopper at Wawa, I can confirm that it is I'll say, yeah, Jedi just being like a speed boxer guy is kind of helping him out a lot here. He's just moving in and punching people in the face.
Wow, guys!
Fucking.
You know, it's kind of.
Do you remember when he did that in Dead Rising?
It's kind of weird that I keep putting these characters in an era where Mr. Ass was the norm because they're so out of place.
He had so many bad gimmicks, honestly.
Mr. Ass, what the fuck?
God, I remember when he tried to have like a singles career and he was the one Billy Gunn.
What an ass.
I thought Mr. Ass would be the kind of guy that would like deliver the stink face again, but
yeah, I forgot.
Unfortunately,
that
the stink face, classic.
What was that like really poorly written Wikipedia article about his finish here that just ended with the sentence where Kishi is known to do that?
Yeah, he just kind of sticks his fucking ash in your face.
Yeah, he actually came up with a metaphor for the move. It's just like,
oh no,
it's just like how awful life is. I'm giving it back to my opponent to make it
what?
Something weird like that.
I just realized watching. Is this a fatal four-way, right?
Yeah.
There's a chance that this will never end. That tends to happen with this kind of match.
Well, then again, I mean, people getting knocked out happens a lot, so. Like that, so.
It does in this game, yeah.
And the worst guy won. I'm a nice man! Yeah, I'm a
nice man! Great. Anal Professor took it.
He likes to shake him. He likes to rub him.
Like, just imagine.
He likes to fuck up.
I just saw the post, Nimrod.
Okay, so this is a match between a guy with a horrible name, Pete Gas.
Good. Yeah.
It just makes him sound like he's gonna fight by means of Baraito.
He's just really sad.
Pete Gus wasn't that interesting.
Why are we fighting Bradshaw again?
Cause you got a feud with him.
Alright, well, can I turn entrances off? No, we can't. Okay, so we gotta sit through that again. Although, I'd like to have another look at Rick's entrance.
Like maybe Kane's intro? Like, that would make sense?
That's the problem, it makes sense.
Oh shit, what's the Undertaker's theme in this, anyway?
Now you're thinking right, man.
No idea, really.
Is Undertaker still Undertaking this? He's not Limp Bizkit, Biker Taker.
I'm not Biker
Taker?
Sure. I guess we'll know once his mugshot pops up again.
Fucking Biker Taker was bad.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you're in his yard. He doesn't like people in his yard. You should stay out of his yard. Because he's the biggest dog in the yard.
Is that his gimmick?
That's what happens when you actually have him do promos, yes.
Oh, jeez.
I think someone said he just looked like someone's dad. OSW review said him. He said, what did he do to lose his powers? Did he, like, go into the Fortress of Solitude and get his powers moved and then go, oh, wait, this is fucking crap. I want my powers back.
Okay, so this match is
I think he became a dad.
This match is going way better than last time.
Because you know Bradshaw's weaknesses. You know he keeps saying maggle all the time.
I suppose I do. I wonder how intricate the combo system is in this game for a wrestling game.
Thunk.
Because you can, like, cancel your auto combo into another basic.
Jesus.
Yeah. He got back up and I just knocked him down again. That was good.
He's a dick, so, you know, just feel free to bury him.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Atomic drop, classic. Wait, cancelling out his whole tray.
You don't give a fuck!
Oh, this got a lot easier since last time. I think he's
I think I missed it. Did you, like, just dance on him, and then as soon as he came in on you, you were like, nope?
Pretty much.
That's beautiful.
God, this guy's not
doing
for pin real. Him!
I'm trying. That Farouk's in the mix, which I'm sure he's gonna, like, throw a punk, give up, and then stop doing anything.
I just remembered how much this game loves interruptions.
That's pretty funny, because I like,
My Isis!
Oh yeah, he did the- what the fuck? He has the Rikishi move!
I'm just pitching like a terrorist wrestler.
That actually happened in Always Sunny.
It actually happened in real life and it was really... It was about as bad as you'd expect.
Yeah. Well,
they had a guy who was like, he didn't want to be stereotyped because he was Muslim, but they made him a villain. Which is. The holy shit, yeah, it went down as well as you probably think.
Every time I try to do the finisher on him, he just wakes up as soon as I hit the L1
button. Was it Iron Sheik?
No, he was just Middle East and he wasn't really a terrorist.
Damn him.
Muhammad Hassan, yeah, that's who I'm thinking of.
Oh, no.
Oh yeah, shit. It's really bad. Muhammad Hassan. He had a bunch of guys in masks come out to do a beatdown. And this is on, and it actually aired the same day as, like, the London bombings.
Oh.
Yeah. And he was actually played by an Italian guy, so... Yeah.
Good job, guys.
Wrestling isn't known for its sensitivity or taste.
Yeah.
Also, I like Rick knocking him into the air and then uppercutting him in midair.
Yeah. He's tackling it pretty hard over.
Rick has the DP.
Well, that his mask was in Tekken.
Break their face.
I would love this game to have his air throw.
Okay.
He just grabs him and starts spinning around.
Alright, this might be it. Please be it. Boom! Okay, there we go.
Spoilers.
We're behind you.
Is this the same match from before?
No, this was better. You beat the shit out of him?
Yeah, you have more chemistry. Now you've worked a match before.
Yeah. Bradshaw was like, oh, let me try that again.
I'm just picturing every time Vic gets hit, he goes,
oh.
I'm almost tempted to watch this match because it has Viscera in it, and that guy's awesome, but...
Pat Patterson, Jesus, he's like an old man.
You know Gangrel's in porn, right? Like, he actually directs it and shit. Good on him!
So just pretending to be it, like, Albinus, that's just... Paul Buchanan.
Yeah, we have Albinus versus this terrifying-looking man.
OSW review with him as one of the boys, like one of the guys who's just kind of there, but never really got very far, and had like lots of stupid gimmicks.
That's kind of, that's always a shame when you hear that happen.
Yeah, but it's also kind of amusing.
Right to censor is funny to me, so it works for me. This, of course, is my character's theme. If we ever get to see her, that is.
I love that theme.
I love how there's an actual song underneath it, but they're just blaring horns over it.
I want to hear its theme. No! No! No!
It censored its own theme music. Beavis with his missile. Alright, let's see how Beavis does against Bull Buchanan. I have to say that is a pretty good name. It's a shame we haven't gotten any, like, backstage fights yet. Those are hilarious. Because you can do stuff like, I think the first time I tried it, Beavis ran me over with a bulldozer or something. And then he threw me in the street and I got hit by a car. It was amazing.
I just realized how appropriate it is to have a right to censor fight Beavis.
Oh yeah, totally.
He's like, stopped. We need to stop this stuff about pyromancy. Pyromancy's not a fucking wizard.
These people are the reason why you can't say fire anymore.
Yeah. And that's exactly what he's a parody of, so. Yeah.
See if he can say fire after this man. Beavis is carrying him like that is so hilarious because he's like a 7-foot gargantuan.
He's thrown by the tie as well.
Yeah. Get out of here, bunghole!
This would totally be an episode of Beavis and Butthead as well, like you know, like a parents group.
Yeah.
You need to stop talking about fire. Damn it, no!
No way, butthole! Yeah, because Beavis is so short, a lot of the grapples just make it look like Bull somehow, like, suplexing him through magic.
That's the magic of business, my friend.
I guess he's switched to Disturbed now, because of the shirt.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I couldn't find any suitable replacement, so he's just showing out Stone Cold right now.
What a mock.
He drinks beer a lot, it's cool.
No, they would love him, though. He would be their favorite. And he's from Texas as well, so...
Is that a thing with Beavis? He likes people from Texas?
No, but, you know, it'll help. On the state.
It won't hurt.
It's on the state as well, you know. Maybe even by school.
No, wait, that wasn't Texas?
I thought it was, wasn't it?
I don't think it's ever sure it was. Was it are?
I thought it was implied to... No, I'm pretty sure it's Texas. Like, in the movie, it has, like, a Texas license plate.
Oh, okay.
When they go to the airport.
Shit, really? I didn't notice that.
Yeah, they don't really make it obvious.
It's not like King of the Hill where they make a point of it, but it just happens to be there.
I think that Mr. Anderson and Hank Hill probably have met each other at some point.
Probably.
No, in exchange for propane.
Remember where Anderson had like the butane, wasn't it?
Yeah.
He made a point of how much he likes butane.
Hank Hill's like, no, butane's a bastard gas. Like... So Beavis is gonna do something eventually. I hope.
Beavis looks so natural with that bat.
Yeah. I made it so that he specializes in hardcore matches, because, you know.
Also, I know you've got, like, the limits of this thing, but it's just like... Beavis, are you wearing boots, a skirt?
No, damn it! They're shorts!
They're cool, okay?
Yeah. I saw that Mr. Ass guy wear them.
What is that move? It's like China's like hip bump, but it ends with like a weird backwards drop kick. I've never seen that.
It might be China's, I don't know. She has a lot of distinct looking stuff in this game, I'm noticing. Like, one of her taunts is just like an evasive like cartwheel backwards.
And then, it's interesting because she'd never had the most versatile moveset.
And they're both phasing to the right there.
God, well, it's wrestling.
It's just not going down.
No!
Oi, butthole!
He tries to pin him. Ah! He's trying to touch me!
Back off, pervert! So I guess he still can't say fire anymore.
Beavis just lost to a total jobber.
There are first triple A's.
He's just gonna go home and unwrap his wiener.
I don't know, maybe that's what this next cutscene will be.
This is the only place where the Vok versus Triple H is going, yeah, whatever. Where's Beavis?
The Rock's still talking. He hasn't stopped for like all night.
Yeah, that's him, alright. I've gotta be honest, these graphics for PS1 games, these graphics aren't bad.
Yeah, really.
The Rock says too much.
Yeah. You smell what The Rock is cooking? He's been cooking all day, too.
I'm gonna talk about these specific ingredients.
Now my secret ingredient for my pot roast is a lot of lemon, you candy ass. Then The Rock comes back and talks some more.
Man, a fight like that makes me want to cook.
And fucking Not the Beautiful People starts playing.
The horrible people. Horrible people.
The polygon people.
I'm starting to realize how good this game was for the time.
Yeah.
Rock is still talking.
Kane versus China with Grandmaster Sexy as the referee.
Who the fuck is booking this? What are the bizarre matches? I don't know if they're just randomized, but you just get the weirdest things.
Well, China won, so I guess it turned out okay.
Why would he be a special bet for that? Just so weird.
And Shawn Michaels, who I hope he loses, because that guy sucks.
I see him in Texas Takedown.
He tries so hard, though.
Did he?
Oh.
That son of a bitch nearly got me!
He's just another generic, like, oh, I'm so hot kind of guy. Like, it's like...
To be fair, he's really, really fucking good in the ring. Mm. To be fair.
So, we have Perry Sander versus Dr. Hibbert. It was the first time he popped up.
But... Who the fuck is Perry Sander? I don't know these people.
He showed up in WCW, and that's all I know about him.
The reason I ask is because I never watched, like, an episode of SmackDown in my life.
Oh, me neither. He's looking very cooked in this game.
Just... Man, yeah, right? Just pull him out of the oven?
Yeah. Did I also put APA protection on Dr. Hibbert, too? What the hell?
Mr. Potato Head? Live action?
And that's his entrance, is he barely knows he's here.
He's just tired?
Yeah.
Wasn't he, like, from Simpsons, or am I just missing something?
Yeah, he's from Simpsons.
Alright, make it sure.
The funny thing is, his appearance formula is mostly taken from a really old site, except for the head. Also, he's just kind of like a, he's kind of a powerhouse boxer dude. Was that one scene?
I'm back. Alright. Why Dr. Hibbert?
because he punches people.
Oh yeah.
I thought he was gonna be like just a guy. The just a guy.
Speaking of, yeah, I hope Kenny Rogers shows up at one point.
Gonna,
he's in
here. Make them play a new game called Shooting Guns at Each Other.
Shooting Guns at Each Other.
Good times.
Yeah.
Nah, they're real. Look.
What the Jesus, Dr. Hibbert? Surprised Saturn's head didn't fly off during that punch.
Well, he's a doctor. He knows the best way to knock people out.
The Smackdown trick!
This is my fist catching trick!
I like the Smackdown trick!
I'm pretty sure at the end of this, one of these guys are gonna be dead because they keep trying to punch each other's heads off.
The fucking.
Jesus.
The entire trick involves winning the belt.
Oh wow, that ended quick.
He just one little ball. Oh, my arms.
No.
Thank goodness I've lost.
Oh,
yeah.
I just realized that's Perry Saturn. And he was always tanned, but he wasn't like that tanned.
Yeah.
This is like the I forgot my sunscreen today, Dan.
He looks more like Ahmed, honestly.
If it lost to a potato?
Yeah, he does kind of look a bit more like Ahmed.
Just kind of like dipped him in the fucking fryer and just forgot about it, didn't put a timer on it, just walked off.
And The Rock is still talking.
I can't do a Rock voice, so I'm not going to try it.
I think that last feud was Dr. Hibbert was saying he was using the sunbed too much. He was skin cancer. He was like, don't tell me what to do, and there's a feud.
Well, if the cancer doesn't kill you, I will now.
Triple H probably was just like, look, man, I got the groceries, everything's good, we can all go home, and Rock's just like, let's finish this, and Triple H is like...
So...
What?
A famous wrestler versus some dude named Rodney.
Rodney.
I don't know if that's... Who the hell is Rodney?
Yeah, I think he's with Pete
Rodney.
Gass.
Oh,
Rodney Fisher?
Mean Street Posse, yeah.
Good old Viscera. Oh, we got a match between Manny and Beavis.
Rodney Fisher and Steely Phil.
I'm so sad that you can only get... Well, the thing is, apparently there's a tutorial where you can hack into the game itself and replace the roster with creative characters, but the tutorial is in gibberish and I can't understand a fucking word of it, so...
What do you mean, like, literal gibberish?
The person writing it clearly, like, English was not their first language.
Oh.
So...
We do need Steely Phil.
What?
I'm scared! There's boobies!
Bernard.
And there's an angry man yelling at them! Ow!
Bernard, these women are too hot! And you know what happens if it gets 88 degrees in here!
Apple. That's the parts store? No, it's Napa, never mind.
A lot of Beavis.
A lot of always pounding ass.
He just really wants the proof that he's the real Huajai.
Those two are just totally the same person. I'm not even...
Except one knows Muay Thai.
Well, Beavis knows Taekwondo boxing!
Close enough.
Just found the generator, then. the funny thing is... So as I mentioned, you can hack the textures in this game, so I could easily replace the logo with that if I wanted to.
I hope you do.
To those watching this video after the fact, our dear buddy Kelexo here has made I Broke Grill I Sorry in the RuPaul is War tag.
I put it in the bucket.
What? Get back in the ring, you assholes! What are you doing? Guys, what are you doing? Get back in the ring!
Bill Bailey has a lot of talents. I don't think wrestling is one of them.
I don't give a fuck about no ring.
He's like not paying attention to the countdown. He goes like, you know, U2's all effects, right?
Brennan, what does it mean when they're counting down to 10?
You lose.
My parents never let me know what happens.
Can you replace like the FMVs and the intros? Because I want his theme to be that Metallica horn cover.
That'd be perfect, but I don't know how possible that is. And that was his finisher, which looks familiar, but I don't know what it is.
I should recognize that. I'm trying to think what it is. Get off me!
Pervert! What the fuck? That's his friend, huh?
I was waiting for that. I was just like, okay, who is it? Oh, well.
Manny is known to do that.
Well, he's got connections. You know, Gus, Rikishi.
The fixer.
Got the best ass on the line.
Manny, you just okay. Change your mind and they're attacking him. What was that?
I just love people. Bill Bailey in this. It's amazing.
Although he ended up looking more like Bruiser Brody, but hey.
It's pretty good.
His tag team partner should be himself from Hot Fuzz.
I don't know who my partner is. They don't tell me anything.
The push. Get off me, asswipe!
Give me all the fart knocker!
Look at this butt knocker!
Bill Bailey doing cartwheels!
They both do, actually.
I mean, at least Beavis is a cartoon, though. The image of Bill Bailey doing it is just...
Well, I mean, like, you know, after so much coffee, second nature.
God! Speaking of which,
yeah.
God!
Rope break, Manny, come on. Nope. Oh no. That did it. What's his one for? Oh, that.
That was a really technical finish.
Yeah.
That was some, like, William Regal shit.
Yeah, again, it was just whatever had the most points I gave him, and that was it. It totally should have been like something like he points him in the face or something, but... The Rock versus Triple H, again, yawn.
Lord Stephen Regal. He's a man. He's a man. Yeah, this thing, and it is. What?
Someone get hit by a car?
What the hell?
He got punished. Jump.
Oh man. He's tired?
Oh, me back.
And then he won anyway.
Dick, I was just really mad about that.
X-Pac is such a fucking idiot.
If I could try to fucking give him shit and he's just like, fucking dick.
And The Rock is still satisfied. He's been talking for like 5 hours about it.
I love how Michael Cole is playable in this.
He's playable in the other game I have, too.
I'd be pretty satisfied after that. Fucking, he tried to jump me, and he's like, oh, I guess people get satisfied when they do a victory. confusing.
That's Crash again versus Ninja Killer. So
he's crashing this game.
Yeah, he certainly is. I don't know why he's showing up so much. He's like a nobody.
Yeah, he was reasonably popular back then.
I guess that explains why he's in this. Then again, Pete Gas is in here too. So. What if the clip's just him in a hotel bed?
Yes.
Look how bad it was taking a nap in a hotel.
It was the 24/7 rule. Like, he had to defend his title anywhere and everywhere.
That's pretty funny.
It's just like a comedy thing, really.
And, you're gonna be Ninja Killer again. I think this is like Goldberg's entrance animation, like.
No. Oh, well, actually. Yeah, it is, it totally is!
I
didn't recognize it at first because you did that weird pose at the start, but yeah, it is.
Yeah, I didn't do that on purpose. That just, I guess they just like hit it or something.
That's weird because this is pre-merger as well. We were still rivals.
Yeah, probably leftover data or something. I don't know.
Well, maybe they just did it deliberately. One of those things where they just go, "Oh, you can just, you know, you can just make Goldberg if you want."
Yeah. Oh, whoa. I wish one of these guys would throw somebody in the back there so we could see, like, the backstage arenas.
Yeah.
Even, like, the game is pointing out, it's back there. Go back there. Crash.
Is he better than the movie?
Well, yeah, that's not saying much.
You know, at least he has that.
What was the movie Crash? Oh, right, okay.
Is that really, really heavy-handed one about racism, and it won an Oscar?
Yeah.
Me and Melv watched that movie because I had to for a class.
Oh, God.
So I just like, hey, you want to watch this and riff on it with me? It's like, all right.
I feel like if it was just about one story, it would have felt way less heavy-handed. Or maybe, like, just two.
But yeah,
it was like eight different pairs of people in the same.
Because we're all affected. We're all affected, man.
And like, it's like that's true, but you didn't portray that very well at all. You just made
it
like.
It's not like a Saturday morning cartoon. Like, racism is bad. Yeah, there wasn't anything more to it.
You have Brendan Fraser with his belty voice going, like, oh, we did a guy named Saddam. Like, really? I swear to God, he calls somebody a bitch in that movie, and it just sounds like he's belching. He's just
God
like,
damn it.
I heard she was a bitch. He says it.
Well, there's also the deleted scene where they defend the hardcore title. But he won't give the belt to someone who's black, and it's like a powerful message.
No, what happens is that guy who owns the shop is like, that's my belt! You took my belt! And then he tries shooting him.
I thought there were no rules! Why can't I shoot this guy?
God, that guy's entire character was just like yelling at people.
Oh, jeez.
What was the class anyway? How not to make a movie with a message?
It was film appreciation, as in you can learn to appreciate, you know,
the films once you watch this one, you'll appreciate other things more.
Exactly.
I was watching
now a lot. You know what a bad film is.
I was watching a lot of Clickhole, and one video summarized that movie pretty good, actually. Mm-hmm. It was a video about like. Because they're parenting those videos, it's like, oh, we talk to, like, couples about how their dates go, and of course it turns into nonsense, but, one was about long-distance relationships, and one of them gives, like, well, you know, she says, like, well, you know, me and her met up long-distance, and long-distance isn't really ideal, but then again, Crash wasn't an ideal movie, and that won an Oscar, so, you know.
Oh, wow.
It's So is Ninja Killer gonna like kill this apparent ninja or not?
He's not, well, Crush isn't a ninja, that's why he's having such a hard time.
Yeah, I can only kill ninjas.
He has to, his finisher, he has to put a mask on their face and then he can kill them.
And Crash wins again. I can't believe this.
God damn it.
He's like the quirky, funny underdog.
And he keeps winning. The fuck is wrong with him?
He's like a terrible Daniel Bryan.
Let's talk about Sausage Party. Get that shit out of here, Zener. We don't talk about that shit no more. Not about that fucking food orgy.
Now that you've seen the frame of the film.
No, I watched that whole fucking scene. That was bad.
Val Venus is. Scott
Kane was. Who's booking this?
Scotty Too Hot is like the closest thing we get to Polar F in wrestling.
What the fuck? Why is Kurt Angle in that match? He's
incredible.
The other thing I can get, kind of get, and he lost. Like Kurt Angle's like in a different league to those other three.
Kurt Angle is a man with a neck. Holy shit.
He had neck fusion surgery, so.
Oh.
Okay, so we're fighting Joey Abs. Joey Abs.
I can't remember the Mean Street Posse at all.
Yeah, I mean, like, so much staying power with these guys. I mean, Pete Gass, Joey Abs, and Rodney.
Jesus.
God. Look at these guys. Like, they're just like three dudes.
I can't even remember.
Like,
Jesus. Rodney, Joey Abs, and it's Joey Abs. It looks like a guy who doesn't have abs.
Yeah.
It's like ironic.
I don't know, Rick Taylor's coming to beat his ass up.
Hello, ladies. It's just his girlfriend with fangs. Hello, lady.
What happened to you, Jen?
He just like, comes out with a hoe train for the all disgusting mutants.
That'd be fantastic. Okay, so we gotta beat up Joey Abs here, which I imagine won't be too hard.
I'd make a joke about this guy, but I can't remember shit about him.
He just looks like a dude you'd see hanging around a CD store.
Buying, like, ironic things.
Yeah. I'm gonna buy this Tito Puente album, ironically. God, he's not really even doing anything, too.
maybe it's like a hipster horror movie fan who's like, oh, original look, hey, Jason called. He wants his look back.
What were you thinking?
Oh, a chainsaw? Haven't seen that before.
Whereas Joey Abs is a completely original concept.
Yeah, he was a little chainsaw and then he pushes the chainsaw in him. Oh, what a cliche death through my torso.
I think we give Joey Abs more personality in like 2 minutes in his entire career.
Joey Abs is a great name. This is his first name and like stomach bumps.
Abs and gas? Hey, what the f- Holy shit.
Oh wow. Oh wow.
Oh, got him.
Joey Abs. So we have Ninja Killer fighting, this old guy? Do you remember this, Bob?
Hang on. General Briscoe, why is he fighting? What the hell?
Who is he?
He was like, oh my god, he's like, backstage guy? He's not a wrestler!
Well, now he is, apparently.
No!
I'm just gonna double check how old he was when this game was made.
He was fucking employee of the month.
Yeah, he was. Area,
so he got a cameo?
When did he retire? Let's see here. Well, to be fair,
that's my son!
He was wrestling in this, but he was like sort of a joke wrestler. Mm. And he was like part of like the Stooges with the other old retired guys, and his highlight was when he wrestled in drag in a bra and panties match. That's Attitude Era for you.
That's wrestling sensibility for you too. It is.
Everyone was getting naked. Naked. Everyone was getting naked. The crazier the better.
Yeah. I'm gonna get a drink while Ninja Killer hopefully beats this guy off.
Alright, everybody, for those who are watching, this is Ninja Killer. That's really all I have to contribute to this conversation.
Remember the Katie? We don't talk about Katie Pick.
Talk about Katie's Zombrecht.
No, we don't talk about that.
Who's Katie Pick?
You don't want
to. You're gonna talk about it now, because I'm curious!
What do you got to say?
What's Katie Vick?
Oh god.
What's what?
Katie Vick.
I'm about to look this bitch up and fucking read it out loud.
Oh no. Trust me, you'll regret it.
Well, fucking give me a TLDR then.
Right, okay, Kane had
first, okay, hold up.
Triple H was in a feud with Kane.
Right.
Kane asked, do you remember who Katie Vick is? It then turned out that Kane killed Katie Vick, and then there's an infamous segment where Triple H has a mannequin in a casket, and he has sex with the mannequin in a casket. There, I told you.
Oh, that's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Shit.
It's yeah, no, but the necrophilia is pretty bad.
Yeah.
I mean, have you seen Skullgirls?
It did have a segment where Triple H was naked in a coffin having sex with a mannequin, though.
I mean,
like, wrestling is terrible at times.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. Thanks, Ether. He looked through spaghetti at the camera and said, I fucked her brains out. Thanks, Ether.
What
did
you even say to that?
That's amazing! What are you talking about? It's fucking great!
I fucked up brain tops.
This is spaghetti!
Well, he have an affair with Miss Pasta or something?
Tortellini's gonna be so upset!
Yeah. When he finds out he's been sleeping around with his wife, Rosato.
The Attitude Era was like everyone remembers it so fondly, but there's so much terrible shit in it.
Also, kind of getting stomped for some reason. I'm guessing as a joke they made this dude really powerful?
Maybe.
That is pretty funny. Yeah. Oh, shit. That was beautiful, thank you.
We will be making less dick references.
Oh. Never mind.
Ah, shit.
Oh, the pedigree. Well, of course that KO'd.
So like I said, he's mostly based off of that one Gato-looking dude from Kensei. Because I had the references moved.
Oh my god, is that Scott Steiner's victory pose?
I don't know, but it
that is, it really is, that's amazing.
Closest thing I can get to the fist pump from Mortal Kombat 1, so.
Scott Steiner is better.
This game really pushing the rocks since I've been playing this, like, they haven't the last time, I think.
Well, I mean, the game is literally, like, named after him, so.
Yeah,
like, one of his catchphrases.
The entire season mode. Like, last time was like, I showed up in a lot of the cutscenes, and now it's just The Rock.
You've been pushed down the card, I'm sorry. The Rock's been politic.
My character hasn't shown up once. Let's see how Manny fares against Funaki. All I remember about this dude is that he was an alt outfit for somebody else in No Mercy.
Didn't Manny try and sell, maybe I'm misremembering, but didn't he try and sell his beer to, like, a Japanese businessman?
No, what happened was that he got, wrapped up in a beard prostitution ring or something.
Oh!
Yeah. I think after this, I might have to stop recording and start it again, because this is already, like, an hour and a half long.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah. It's passed pretty quickly, goddamn.
Can I ask, what's this game's name again? Name of the game?
Smackdown 2, Know Your Role.
Okay. I thought it was, like, versus Rock or something, because The Rock sure does appear often.
Well, that is his Know Your Role is his catchphrase, so kind of.
One of his, like, 50 catchphrases.
Yeah. It was like they got to the fifth game when they finally stopped using his catchphrases as the subtitles.
Yeah. I gotta say, once I get some money, I'm gonna totally order one of the PS2 games. Because I don't think I could find it in the game store I went to. Then again, I kinda stopped looking when I found the fight stick, so...
I'll have to pick up, like, a wrestling game one day and just make some people.
It's fun.
Yeah, make sure it's one of the games that's actually fun to play, though. So that's kind of the main
thing. Yeah. I remember one of the ones I picked up, I made myself in it, and...
I think we actually
played entire,
that.
Yeah, the entire fucking finisher was just a series of nut shots.
You gotta, like, strutted away at the end.
Yeah, like... It was all a bunch of different... like speeds.
Yeah.
Like there was one that like took forever to line up the blow, but whenever like it threw the punch, it did it in like half a second.
Yeah, that was the one we played. And that was one of like the modern ones that like, yeah, they're not good.
It was
that
so
was
funny.
The one where I made that where I created Miss Fan Service.
Yeah.
Even though it was just like a bunch of crap.
I think it was just like a big red woman. That's all I remember.
Blue hair, I think.
Did you just make Marge Simpson?
Wow, yes,
Marge definitely has red skin.
Angry Marge Simpson.
Oh no.
Big difference.
So Manny's kind of stomping right now.
Manny's fucking mad, D.
Here comes Funaki's friend.
God, this game and the interruptions.
This is Funaki.
So, yeah, like I said, Funaki was actually just an alt outfit for Taka here. In, Mercy. Which was always kind of weird because I, like... You gotta think, like, they had to play somewhat differently in real life. I mean, not playing, but, you know?
Yeah,
well, they weren't twins. They were, like, different wrestlers.
Yeah. Not according to, No Mercy. Although, to be fair, I make different characters, like, alt outfits all the time just to cram as many characters as I can in there. And also, E1. That was the move that knocked him out.
That was like a weak-looking Hokurana, okay?
Manny was just really, really tired, and he fell asleep. Oh, Road Dog!
Oh, Road Dog.
What, you didn't know?
I suppose my ass better call somebody.
Eddie Guerrero versus China, okay.
The entirety of China, or...?
Whole fucking country?!
No, he's only fighting her leg, that's kind of the...
Oh, okay.
The rest of her is just like, I don't know, like, eating dinner or something.
Well, yeah, because, she was his mamacita.
so much Rock punishing.
You're talking too much! Shut the fuck up! Here's WWF SmackDown 3, shut your mouth!
God damn.
Everybody hates Rock?
The Good Father versus Gangrel.
Oh god, the Good Father?
Or the Godfather just kinda ended up looking like a white collar Stevie Wonder.
I just want the Good Father to just be like, I'm the Godfather series, but I'm good.
Well, the Good Father is the censored version.
Yeah. Scotty Too Hotty fights somebody's dad.
I like how Val Venus was still Val Venus in, when he was part of Might to Censor, though.
Yeah.
He still has his porn star name.
Yeah, these matchups are getting way too random now. Fatal four-way between four people that I don't care about.
Stone Cold Steve Austin's back again. Fuck ass.
Man, I haven't seen The Undertaker yet. I want to know which version it is.
Yeah, that, yeah. Oh,
God damn it, I lost. I was saying Texas, that's some baby back bullshit.
Vince McMahon and Triple H are yelling at The Rock.
It's a barbecue.
He literally says yelling at.
You've been talking way too goddamn much. We're losing ratings.
Yeah, but you know what? Stone Cold is in the arena.
What does that matter? It doesn't matter that Stone Cold's in the arena.
What? You wanna come say that shit to my face?
I'm just letting you know he's in my King of Fighters team now.
Oh shit.
And that's the bottom line.
Because, why is that the bottom line?
I don't fucking know.
It just is.
It is fucking not American.
What's going on here?
Said. Something like he said so.
What?
I was here the whole time, you son of a bitch. I am The Rock.
Yeah, I remember this stuff.
That is amazing.
How are you gonna blow up your RV now?
They made an entire cutscene so you can fuck up their trailer. That is amazing.
Blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah, blah.
Was
now you gotta get a Ford pickup truck. Like a real Texan.
They just
I know that pisses you off.
They just followed up a cutscene with another cutscene.
You fucking Yankee.
Your big news is that he's a referee in the next match. Alright. Not that he's wrestling or anything, he's just calling the shots.
Fucking Stone Cold's demands have been answered. Now he's making the rules.
I'm gonna save this really, really quick and then restart the stream.
This is fun.
Yeah.
Game is great.
I love this game.
Yeah, it's pretty good. I think the gameplay has definitely held up. Alright, let me restart the stream real quick then.